we go. I don't want it to auto-select. I'll just switch it over to left right now. Mojave Tower, November Tango 024, requesting clearance to Los Angeles. Or Mojave Ground, sorry. Oh, sorry, thank you. For
connected to pilot edge.
Mojave Ground, November 024 Tango, requesting clearance to Los Angeles. Okay, I just filed it. I'll refile it again. If it's filed or not. Homepage. KMHV Chet.
November 2FS0 at 20 left is the option.
That's not all those. It's supposed to be KMHV. I must have retyped that. HV. All right, let's make sure that's right. KMHV. I see what I did wrong. Typed that in completely wrong. If that actually gets through. If we don't make it by the end of Pilot Edge here, we'll just fly it off the network, but there we go. There, right. Mojave Ground, November 024 Tango, requesting clearance to Los Angeles. Ah, shit. I have a GPS. Sorry, I'm not sure of the code.
That's fine. Golf. Roger, excuse me. Clearance on request. Stand by. There's 214. Is that a jet or a prop?
It's a turboprop. Sorry. Departure runway 30 to Lake Quantico. Departure frequency 124.55, squawk 5021, November Tango, or November 024 Tango.
November 024 Tango, it's runway 30, departure procedure.
Departure. November 024 Tango, number runway 30, depart for procedure.
024 Tango, read back correct.
San Luis Ground, Air 604, Mike Bravo, Bear runway 29 in Charlie.
Departure procedure.
November 4, Mike Bravo. Taxi departing via Alpha Gaday, you pass the cat 2, we'll see if the cat 3.
I don't know what the runway procedure.
November 604 Mike Bravo, taxi departing via Alpha, you pass cat 2, we'll see if the cat 3.
I have nothing for.
Thank you. And 2 FSC is clear, 20 about to be taxi
back to the level. 2 FSC, taxi departing, get in.
Ah.
And negative taxi request back to the level.
2 FSC, my bad. From the 20 left field taxi via hotel, Charlie, taxi via Charlie.
Okay, taxi
via
Charlie, back to
the
level.
Thank you. 2-1. Mojave Ground, November 024 Tango, ready to taxi at the hangars.
November 024 Tango, Mojave Ground, number 30, taxi via Charlie Alpha.
November 024 Tango, taxi via Charlie Alpha. To help here where Alpha's gonna go. Yep, that's where I thought. I just wanted to look outside here for a second. Look to our left, I don't see anything. We lose. flaps to takeoff position. Everything really looks good to go. They're going to be going offline here in about 4 minutes, so we'll see if we can procedure thing is definitely different. Great. I thought that looked kind of... No. Insert waypoint, which would be SHA... SHAWK. All right, they're going to go offline in a minute. We're not going to request with the tower and stuff. We're going to kind of go through the motions of the flight. Well, now that we know the departures and... Pilot edge now. Now we're going to do and we're going to see our flight stuff here. Alright. So that's cool. We learned some stuff here on this departure. So we're cleared here. Let's get out on the runway. Engines up to about 80, 70, 80, right about there for takeoff, release the brakes. Going up. Not sure that that was right either. Oh. You know why? Because we did heading. See, we would have screwed that up. Oh no. Not sure I can activate this leg. Oh. It just decided to switch. Well, it's a good thing we didn't. We're gonna end up going to straight to Jared here, which would be a no-no normally. Alright, let's zoom this in a little bit here, which is something I could have done. Climbing at about 170. I'm gonna get my speed up to 200. But I'm happy with where we're at with the. Probably push it a little bit more here up to. So we don't over torque it. No. Lift up the flaps here. Frame rate's doing good. I have SkyMax 4 with real weather connector in it. Looks really nice. Never liked this north up thing. Alright, we're about 8 nautical miles, about 2 minutes from our next turn at Jared. Enjoy the scenery. Absolutely beautiful. Alright, something I gotta do here. Start getting in Los Angeles stuff up here. Because we aren't going to get vectors. Alright, so. Alright, make a left turn here in 2 nautical miles. ATIS 113.8. So we'll get that tuned in here. I won't have to worry about any of this other stuff. Nobody else's. Alright. quite a ways, 102 nautical miles away. Well, you know what? I didn't have this on. We can monitor it. When it kicks in, it will let us know. Alright, so. Do a lot of switching here, but I think we'll.
Approaching altitude.
Alright, coming up on our altitude. I do believe that that's Air Force Base over here, and that's why we make all these turns around it. Oh yeah, that is Edwards Air Force Base. Dang. Alright, so we are going to look at some of this stuff here on my side, other screen that you can't see. Alright, we probably want to cross Palmdale at 7,000. So, descend and maintain 7,000 here. Down 1500 feet and see where, if we can get down there. No. That was my fault. I think that's most will drop the nose. At altitude, we probably could take this down to 1500 RPM and yes, I didn't do the landing and the taxi lights like I should have. We're under 10,000, I'll do that. I'm telling you though, I'm gonna love the ATC stuff. I'll learn it. I pick up pretty quick. Some wind there. Palmdale. That's where we are at. We are inbound to Bogot. Perfect. We'll probably slow down a little bit when we get down there. Very nice clouds. Oh yeah, we had gained some speed. I do have the autopilot throttle on right now. I don't know how to exactly activate it in the plane, but if you set it on the buttons, it does work. The auto throttle. Bit of an outside view of what's going on. Definitely bumpy. Minutes for chemo, and at chemo we will start heading towards darts. Now, when we get to darts, I would start to assume that we, maybe Seal Beach, not sure. Chart is not to scale, so I have no idea. Very pretty. I don't know. We'll see how with more clouds and stuff, but SkyMax 4, I'm running 30 frames, 31, 32, which is probably where I was running before with SkyMax 3.3, I think it was. But I've got the range on these clouds all the way up. I better keep that chart up, know where my altitudes are. Well, 7,000 all the way in. Better flip the, I know I could have it on auto, but the fuel here is uneven, so we'll get it down close to even, and then we'll, if we get it down there. There could be like a GoPro view. Everybody always kind of does these things. Frame rate's taking a little bit of a dive here. I'll have to play with how far the distance is, but so that will take me back there. Don't have the right key on there either. People have said that as they come into Los Angeles, they get decreased frame rates, so I don't know that I've ever really flown in. It might be more the scenery loading than anything. Look at our chart here, GPS, it looks like LAX is to our right. Yeah, there are lots and lots of buildings down there. I may have to click in there and adjust that. Not quite sure where I have the scenery setting, but it's going pretty smooth if I don't turn. I'm surprised I just don't hear it. That's not normal. In real life, I'm sure they'd be giving us vectors already, but I'm not sure. Let's see if Bob Hope, if we can hear that one. Stunned that we do not have frame rates picking up a little bit. It's that downtown area. Here, since we're not on any network rendering options, let's see. Number of objects extreme. Let's go with tons and see. Let's see if this reloads a little bit better here. I know I cut it that by half, but it'd be a good. Sorry about the delay here. But 14 frames a second just isn't going to do it for me. Got it up to 20. I can live with that. That's a little bit of an increase. Yeah, not quite as many houses. Turn towards LAX at 280, so let's go for, we do have a headwind, not much, oh no, we kind of have a tailwind. Departure 135.65. Let's see what that says.
Los Angeles INTL. 2100 Zulu weather. Wind calm. Visibility more than 10. Sky clear. Temperature 10. Dew point 1. Altimeter 3016. Arriving and departing runway 07 left. Advise on initial contact, you have kilo.
Alright, 07 left. So, if we change our heading,
Los Angeles INTL information kilo. 2100 Zulu weather. Wind calm.
So that's. We're going to have to fly by the airport.
Temperature 10, dew point 1. Altimeter 3016. Arriving and departing runway 07 left. Advise on initial contact, you have kilo. Los Angeles INTL information kilo. 2100 Zulu weather. Wind calm. Visibility more than 10. Sky clear. Temperature 10. Dew point 1. Altimeter 301. Los Angeles INTL information kilo. 2100 Zulu weather. Wind calm. Visibility more than 10. Sky clear.
I want to get ourselves down to about 3,000 feet.
Altimeter 3016. Arriving and departing.
I'm going to slow us down to 170
left.
Just to get ready for this. There we go. 111.1. And our course for this will be 071. How do you change the course when you're not on it? Oh. There we go. Alright, so now we go back to Skyview, and we go back to navigation. I see what it did there. Port is off of our nose. I'll zoom in a little bit here. Oh, in. Alright, our heading. Kind of want to get us to a point where we're off to the side a little bit here. Oh, you know what? I never went down. Oops. My fault. All right, let's go on heading mode. I believe that's where we will be landing. The altitude. Here, where do we want to be? Not sure how far away that is. We'll try it. RIBBN. Well, we can go all the way out. Excert. EXERT. Is it 17 miles, 5 minutes? All right, well, set ourselves up for a nice long approach. Maybe that isn't as far as I really want to go. Let's try to delete. Let's go back to heading. I have it on here. Let's see which one. That's kind of far. Let's try ribbon. RIBBN. It's only 5 miles. I like that. Let's do direct to this waypoint. At ribbon, we want to be at 4,000 feet. Well, we're at 3. We'll intercept the glide slope. We'll do a little bit of manual flying from there. And no, probably no controller in their right mind would ever give you this type of approach, but hey. We got our frame rates back up now that we don't have the scenery in our view. We are 1 minute from ribbon. And I'm going to set my speed to 120. Then we'll put down flaps 1. There is a technical sheet on this, but away and alright, I'm going to take over so we can kind of intercept it. I'm going to make a left turn here to get off. Not sure, will it take us back over there? Yeah, it will. Take that off, will it let us just turn? Yes. Alright. Alright, we're gonna make our a little bit of a right turn here. Airspace. Intercepting the approach. station. We'll go on approach. Glide slope has not been intercepted yet. I don't think. It does have us descending a little bit. And we're 14 nautical miles away. I'm thinking we intercepted the go to full. We're 13 nautical miles away, but I do not feel bad about dropping down the gear. We'll get our landing lights on. Just curious if it'll take us back up to 3,000. That's what I was worried about. I do believe the glide slope is below us now. I'm gonna try to force it down here a little bit. According to the glide slope on there, it is above us. So, we'll just kind of hold our altitude here. I can see the runway. Showing that we're 6.6 miles away, nautical miles. There, I think I see the glide slope getting ready to intercept us here. Yeah, I did a lot of screwy things on this flight, but I think we're going to get there. Intercepting the glide slope right now. Just get my airport diagram up on my other screen and 07 left. And we'll turn off the runway to the left and then we'll have plenty of places to park. Probably go back over towards the administration, so we'll get to go down the runway quite a ways unless we get off right away. Alright, back on the screen here, we are 3.7 miles away, we're at 500 feet. Probably want to get off at B3, which is way down at the other end, but alright. I have the throttle. I have was a little scared that I was taking over the controls there. Alright, now I'm low. on that way away is there should be some buildings. We are on taxiway Bravo. Take off the landing lights. at C7. So I probably want to see C3. C6. C4 would have done it. That's all right. C3 will work. And we'll let everybody out. Quite the flight. All right, until next time.